Hi guys, welcome to the Shannon Show podcast. So today's podcast is going to be a review of episode 5 of Love Island. So obviously today there was an elimination and new girl Molly Mae comes in. Molly Mae was definitely looking better than she did in her promo. She looked really pretty and obviously for her date she picks Tommy first. They hit it off. Tommy's looking like he's into her and it's looking like they could be a possible couple. Obviously, it's the girls picking the boys, and in the beginning of the episode, it kind of looks like the only boy that she's really into getting to know or interested in coupling up with is Tommy. She also picks Curtis, but he like immediately tells her that him and Amy are going strong and that he'd like to continue with that and that their relationship is solid. Honestly, I feel like that whole thing when he kisses Amy before he goes for the date and after he comes back on the date was cringe. Hella cringe. And also, Miss Amy, don't keep your eggs in one basket. It seems like she's holding on to Curtis as one of her eggs in her basket very tightly. I still don't buy this relationship. A lot of people, I guess they're like the first relationship on Love Island that's looking like a solid relationship, and usually people root for kind of the first relationships that form. I still don't buy it. I was really surprised that Curtis's head wasn't swayed, but I just don't know. It just doesn't feel, I don't know. It still feels like very friendshipy to me. Like, I don't feel their chemistry or anything. And honestly, I know it sounds bad, but I just want someone to come in there and cause drama and split them up. But let me know what you think. Do you think that, you know, Curtis and Amy are the real deal and that their end game? Or do you think that perhaps there is a lack of chemistry and that their relationship is vulnerable? It's only been 4 days, so I'm not sure why they're being so loyal to each other. Because, as I said, like, I just don't see chemistry with them. But let me know what you think. Lucy's getting jealous now, and I don't think it's because she likes Tommy. I think it's because all the attention isn't on her anymore, because it's a bit of an ego boost. Obviously, Tommy and Joe, they are looking like... Obviously, Tom and Joe, I think that they are probably, like, the best-looking pair in the house right now. So, obviously, she's got a bit of an ego boost that the best-looking guys in the house are lusting after her. So, obviously, that's a big ego boost. And now that this other girl has come along and now Tommy's head is being swayed, now she's feeling a bit jealous. So, yeah, she talks to him and I'm not sure if her jealousy will make her head turn completely. So Tommy, obviously Joe's still in the picture. Joe's been really chill this episode. He hasn't really been that insistent. At the beginning of the episode, before they all know that there's an elimination, Joe's been kind of laid back. He hasn't been really like intensely pursuing Lucy. But yeah, obviously she feels quite jealous. And also Yuande, we see her a bit more. You know, she's been, you know, the producers haven't been giving her really near enough airtime that she should be getting. But we see her, and obviously, you know, they're kind of talking, speculating about the girl while she's on the date with Tommy. And, you know, obviously, I hate when people, like, bitch about somebody, and then they're like, oh, but I bet she's really nice. And Yuande was just like, what does her being nice have to do with anything? And I completely agree with my girl Yuande, because at the end of the day, this is a fucking game. This is a game. So what does her being nice have to do with anything if she's potentially stealing your man? So, yeah, I just need a lot more of this bluntness, a lot of this ruthlessness. I feel like everyone's so nice on this season. I want the dickheads. I want the bitches. I want drama. It's all very dry at this point in the season. So obviously, Tommy now knows that Lucy and Molly are after him. So he's got that massive ego boost now. Of course, Anton is now after him too, as we saw at the beginning of the episode. And he's just loving all the attention and he's basking in it. So Sharif pulls Anna to the side to tell her, like, he really likes her and he wants to, you know, carry on with what they have. But really, he should have pulled her to the side last episode and told her. But he's told her now. So now I was pretty sure at that point that Anna was going to pick Sharif to stay. So midway through the episode, Molly Mae's keeping her options open and she says that she's interested in either Tommy, Michael or Callum, which is quite interesting because in yesterday's episode, I thought that who would be up for the chopping block would be either Michael or Callum. So obviously, at this point, if she was to save either Callum or Michael, that would switch up who would go home. So Michael smells that he's in hot water and starts talking to Yawande Day and putting it that work. As we saw in the challenge, he gives her a quite passionate kiss. So he's trying to solidify his spot. And Yawande Day basically says that she would save him if it got down to the nitty-gritty and it was looking like he was going to go. So at this point, I was thinking that Michael was going to be safe. And I was thinking, well, it was probably looking a bit like either Callum or Anton. So there's like a cowboy slash striptease challenge with the boys. And Tommy and Lucy have a kiss in front of Joe, which was quite awkward. But Joe was like, okay, bet. And he went in on his striptease and him and Lucy had a really long, passionate kiss. Yeah, I enjoyed the stripteases. I think the best bums out of the boys were Sharif's, Michael, Tommy, and I think the person with the best bum would probably have to be Curtis. Curtis is thick. Like, he's a bit like thick-bodied anyway. Like, he's got a bit of a chubby dad body going on. But yeah, he's thick. Like, I feel like he's got a bigger bum than I do. And I thought that I had a big bum, but I think Curtis has a bit bigger bum than me, Shadi. So the moment we've been waiting for, the recoupling. And I'm so happy that they didn't put in any breaks, because I tell you, I just didn't have any patience for that type of editing today. And so obviously, Amy and Curtis, they coupled up. Obvious. Anna and Sharif, obvious. I thought it was obvious anyway. Obviously, they're trying to make this edit, like, who's she going to choose? Anton or Sharif? And obviously, she picked Sharif. At that point, I was thinking maybe Anton could be a gunner. But at that point, I was thinking it's either Anton or Callum. It all depends on who Amber chooses. After that, obviously, it's Amber's go and she chooses Anton. I wasn't that surprised because they've bonded and they've had a friendship. Callum, we haven't really seen much of him on screen. He's been the nice guy, but he hasn't been really proactive. Perhaps, obviously, Yawande was talking about being loyal to Michael, but obviously, if Callum was a bit more proactive with Yawande, perhaps maybe that would have turned into something. But at this point, I knew Callum was a goner. I was pretty sure Callum was a goner, especially after Michael kissed Yawande. So yeah, I knew at that point that Callum was a gander. Lucy, obviously, again, another edit. Who's she going to choose, Joe or Tommy? I already knew she was going to pick Joe. You could just tell that she likes Joe more. She just liked the attention from Tommy. And obviously, she picked Joe. And you could tell that Tommy was annoyed. And I don't think he was like heartbroken, but obviously it's a bit of a bruise to his ego, because he probably does think that Lucy is, you know, the best girl for him in the house, the most attractive girl in the house. That's probably what he's thinking. But obviously, just to have almost the title of having the best looking girl in the villa, I feel like him not having that and him losing to Joe, of all people, I feel like he has this thing where he sees them both as like different people or different types of boys. And I feel like his ego was definitely bruised by that. So after Lucy didn't pick Molly May, I knew Molly May was instantly going to pick him. One, she did mention Callum, but of course, Callum still hasn't been that proactive. And Tommy is better looking than Callum, in my opinion. And two, I don't think the producers would allow that to run. I'm pretty sure that if Molly May picked Callum, the producers would have been like, cut, redo that. So yeah, and it was really sad because they did like a cut to Callum and just standing there, and you could tell that he knew that he was going home. You knew that he was going home. I felt really sorry for Callum. And obviously, I wanted Anton to go. Like, you know my motto now, Anton can get in the bin. I wanted Anton to go, but, you know, fair dues to Anton. He actually has been grafting. He's actually been making an effort to be friendly with everyone. So at least if nobody's attracted to him, he could have the fallback of, well, I'm friends with somebody. And, you know, if they're not in a couple, then that could be something to fall back on. So yeah, Anton's still in there and Callum's a goner. And that's how the episode ends. And I wasn't going to cry because I'm not that invested in this show, but it was sad. I was sad that Callum went, and you know, he was saying, you know, he didn't find his wife on the show, which he was never gonna do. But yeah, it was a bit sad that he went. They have episodes on Sunday now. Usually, it's Monday to Saturday, but I guess I think they're taking a break. They do their breaks now on Saturday, and then on Sunday they carry on. So maybe Saturday is after sun. I haven't looked at the schedule or anything. So I'm guessing Saturday is now, Saturday is now after sun, and Sunday they resume the episodes. But they've got a new guy in, his name is Danny. We've got another kind of light-skinned black guy / mixed race guy, average looking. I really can't believe they didn't find anyone better looking than Michael. Out of all of the applications that they received from light-skinned black guys / mixed race guys, this is the quality that we are getting on our screens. But you know, I guess we'll see when he gets there. What's his personality like? Is he gonna come and spice things up? I don't think he has the his looks have the capacity to shake things up per se, but you never know, he could be a Theo and just come in and annoy people and spice things up that way. I guess that's the end of the podcast. I guess I'll see you on Sunday then. I'm going to have a little break tomorrow. Hopefully it's not raining tomorrow. I haven't checked the weather. But let me know what your thoughts were on tonight's episode. I don't think anyone's really surprised that Callum went home. It was either Kim or Anton. I didn't think Amber would be loyal enough to Callum to keep him. She's kind of been palming him off the whole season so far. Was going to go. But let me know if you were shocked that Lucy did pick Joe. Let me know if you thought that maybe Tommy had his way. And who do you think's head could be turned by the new Islander Danny? I don't think he'll turn anyone's head, to be honest. Till next time, guys. Bye.